See, it's not a matter of convincing. It's like this, we've been in the memory business for the last 20 years and we're manufacturing memory. Memory is such a volatile industry that, you know, very few people in the world have really survived. They understood that if a company like Symphonix, and I think about two or three companies in the world have really survived on memory for the last 10 years, even 10 plus years, they realize that they need a partner like us. And plus, we are a manufacturing base, we are a manufacturing facility in India, we have global presence, we've got presence in Singapore, Middle East, all across. So they realize that, yes, they should, you know, tie up with us and work. And currently we're manufacturing motherboards already. So they saw our facility, they understood the capability which Symphonix has, and they understood the roadmap which we're working on in terms of, you know, where we're looking at close to about 100 to 150,000 motherboards a month. So they thought this was a good opportunity for them. They were looking at a strong company who's going to be there for manufacturing. So manufacturing from, you know, right down to complex testing, support, service, all that. So it was like a, you know, ideal combination for both. We were also looking for somebody like that, and that's how the whole tie-up happened. No, it's not. It's not going to. It's now, you know, we've got other partners we're working with now. We've got, you know, we're handling right from the low end to the higher end. We've also recently launched our sub 10,000 rupee PC. People have been talking about the sub 10,000 rupee PC, but nobody's really delivered. Here, Symphonix, its advantages are memory, motherboard, or components, which we already, you know, close to about 40% of the component we've already taken care of. So, coming up with a 10,000 PC for us was easy. We did a US$199 PC at Jitex 2 months ago. That clicked off really well. So, you know, we've been working on that, and now we've, you know, got it into India with everything paid, excise, everything at close to, you know, sub 10,000, less than 10,000 rupees. So, we're looking at the market which is there. We're going to be delivering an ideal machine, a PC with a monitor, with an LCD monitor, you know, keyboard, mouse, everything within that. So it's going to make sense. Yeah, definitely. We are already in the process of expanding our production line. It's already in place. Machines are in 300 machines. They're going to be set up very soon. So obviously there's going to be expansion. There's going to be a lot of stuff happening. We feel that 100,000 motherboards per month is a very, you know, easy figure for us to achieve. And that's the plan which we, you know, that's my ambition which I need to cover within the next 6 months. So 100,000 volts per month, you know, and we should be able to get there within the next 6 months time. Yeah, we are. See, currently we have like 20 offices in India and 11 offices all over the world. We are now having selected partners who are going to be working with us exclusively for VR in India and all over the world. So there's definitely a lot of focus on this, on VR. Our strategy is that, you know, VR has a very good product, has the technology. The main thing is they have the, you know, embedded technology, which is the CPU on board. So with that, you know, with our warranty support, all that, you know, the channel is very excited about the whole thing. We've been doing a series of channel shows. We've been doing close to about 20 channel shows within the last 2 weeks. And we should be finishing that by the 2nd of Feb. We would have covered close to about 25,000 kilometers, and close to more than 3,000 dealers have been met. And out of that, we've picked up selected people, you know, and we are forming a team which is going to be exclusively working with VR and us, you know, basically selling our products, Symphonix VR products, all across. So we should be having close to about 80 to 120 partners. We're looking at a lot in BNC class. You know, everybody focuses on A class, Delhi, Bombay, Bangalore, Chennai, Calcutta, but that's okay. But I think the cheap PC market is definitely there in major metros, but definitely in BNC class cities, especially C class cities, that's where the huge market is, and that's where we are looking at really being aggressive. We are doing shows in BNC class cities, and we're going to be doing, you know, channel program. We have a channel program running right now based on VR motherboards. We've got a lot of stuff happening. We're giving away, you know, cools and various goodies are available. Well, we, like we started with motherboards, we've launched motherboards. We're working on the thin clients. Thin clients is a huge market. Banks, all the thin client market is where we are working with VR. With that, we're talking about the tablet. We're looking at laptops. We're launching the whole range of laptops. We're also talking about all-in-one. The all-in-one is a very good, exciting product with some products.
Right.
And if you really look at it, I feel my product which I like the best is all-in-one. You know, it's everything within that, you know.
Right.
So, I think we're going to be, there are companies, there are multinationals who already launched it. But we will be able to launch it at a very good price, which will be for the mass market. You know, people don't need to look at spending 40,000 or 35,000 to get an all-in-one. We're looking at a very, you know, sub 20,000 all-in-one, which we will launch very soon with VR. I don't think the challenge or hurdle is there. I'll tell you, so people know Simtronics. People trust Simtronics. People know Simtronics warranties are there. We give lifetime warranty on our memory. We give 3 years warranty on our motherboard and all that stuff. People know and trust Simtronics. They know if Simtronics is going to be doing something, they will do a good job. VIA and Simtronics are working where Simtronics is going to handle all the RMA, all the warranty support, all everything for them in India. So this relationship is definitely going to happen. It's not going to be a hurdle. It's going to be, I think, it's a very exciting thing what's happening. It's communication which will go to the end users, end partners, end customers about VIA, and I am definitely sure that VIA, within the next 1 year, we're looking at close to about 5 to 7% market share, and then, you know, doubling every year over the next 3 years. We have close to about 22 service centers and support centers right now in India and all over the world, wherever we sell. Our distributors who basically, like I told you, we have 11 offices. And our distributors who are not our offices, they become our support centers there.
Okay.
So for our international support centers, we give swap warranties. We just swap it. And for our Indian, we have repair centers, RMA centers. And we are looking at tying up with third-party warranty services, which will, you know, take our plus our offices, plus warranty. We should have about close to about 60-70 service centers all across the country very soon. We are working on increasing our office strength to about close to about 30 offices by the end of this year. So, team is increasing. We've got a very good management team. And we will have close to about 75 to 80 service centers by the end of this financial year. We are talking to 3-4 companies right now, so we're looking at who gives us the best deal, the best support. So negotiations are on, more or less we finalize. Some places we already finalized, some places we are on the verge of finalizing that. We have our own brand on the market, but we don't do contract manufacturing in terms of for other brands. We do it for companies who are not into the, let me say, IT space, who are not a company. We don't make motherboards, we don't make memory for a lot of companies in India. We do it on a global basis. If some, we're doing it for some companies in Germany and some companies in the UK who want memories to be made by us for them. Yeah, definitely. I think definitely 2011 will have a huge marketing, manufacturing facility coming up. It's just already on the plan, it's already on the cards. We're looking at a global expansion also. Depends upon how our global operations move. Middle East is a very big hub for us. And we sell into Egypt, we sell into Syria, we sell into UAE. So possibly we're looking at Latin America. So we're on that mindset whether we should set up an international manufacturing facility in Latin America and Brazil or in the Middle East. We will have one plant in India and one plant on a global basis. So currently we've got like a plant in Singapore where we manufacture memory.
Yeah.
We will have another plant in possibly Middle East or in Latin America for motherboards and other product lines.
Okay.
Yeah, we're looking at tablets. First of all, the PC market is so huge. The motherboard market is so huge. I think we're the only company currently in India who is manufacturing motherboards. So we're looking at growing that to one of the other competitors. There's definitely an A segment and a B segment. And we're very much predominant in the B segment. We want to make a major market share of the B segment. That's where we are working on as far as motherboard is concerned. Then with desktops, with our 10,000 rupee PC and the whole PC range which we're doing, we're looking at being a major player into the PC market too. And our advantage, like I told you, is we manufacture 40% of the component of the PC. So that makes sense for us. And then the PC is there. We've got SimBooks, which we work very closely with IBM, Ubuntu-based. If you work very closely with IBM and the Lotus Suite and all that. Right. So then we've got tablets coming in. So we've got all-in-ones. We've got a product called Keyboard PC, which is just going to be, it's a new product which we're going to launch very soon. It's just a keyboard and the whole PC is within the keyboard. The CD-ROM, the CD-Writer, DVD Writer, the hard disk, everything is made within the keyboard. You just need to take the keyboard and plug it in into a monitor or anywhere and just use it. So these are the product lines we're working on. We have always tried to innovate and be one of the first movers in the industry. So I think we will keep up to that. It's going to be corporate, it's going to be education, it's going to be end customer, end users. It's going to be a mix of everything. Nobody can just say that I'm going to be only focusing on corporate. Right. It's going to be, education, definitely segment is one. I've seen a lot of buzz over the sub 10,000 PC which we launched 2 days ago. People have been getting back to us and talking in numbers. We've had responses from education. We've had responses from hospitals. We've had responses from end customers and we've had responses from schools. And even corporates are looking at talking to us now. So I think definitely it's going to be, we're going to have, I won't say that it's going to be only corporate or whatever. It's going to be some share of every market. But there are different market segments. That's what I said. There are total different market segments. And we run a different market segment. If we look at it, we'll be competing with companies like HCL, Wipro, or local domestic manufacturers, Acer, HP, are all basically international MNC, Dell. They're an MNC which is there. So I think we are working on that. We have a strategy in mind. Let's see. We're keeping our fingers crossed. See, trends are definitely the iPad is there, they're there to stay, tablets are coming in, netbooks are going to be there, but desktop market is going to continue its growth. Understand, the desktop market is so huge. Laptop market and these markets are small. People talking about 30% jump or 20% jump in laptops, definitely. And whether it is 5% or 8% jump in the desktop market. That's fine, that's going to happen. But look at the size of the desktop market. Yeah. If you try to compare numbers, how many sold desktop vis-a-vis numbers of laptops. Percentages might sound different, but numbers are different. So, I think desktop market is still there to stay. It's definitely going to be, has to be there. There are total differences between using a desktop and a laptop. Right. You will never use a laptop for gaming. You prefer, gamers use desktops and high-end desktops, like with 16 GB of memory on their desktops and all. That's something which you cannot get on a laptop. Right. So, people, I think what I feel is going to happen is, they're going to be desktops and laptops both in everybody's houses.